Spider has been trading on the Australian share market for more than a decade. These videos are designed to help you if you too enjoy trading Australian shares or trading full stop. If you are sick of being someone else's employee, or maybe if you just want to make a few extra bucks, or maybe you ultimately want to have It's a Wonderful Life, hopefully the videos in this series will be able to help you. We don't give tips. This is all about what goes on inside your head when you're a trader. Hope you enjoy them. Trading indicators, part one. It's taken me a while to get to this subject, and to be honest, I'm not sure why. It's actually the most basic of all basic subjects on trading, particularly technical analysis, which is the stuff that I do. The trouble is that simple things are often the hardest to explain. But we have to start somewhere, so let's start with price action. The most basic and most important indicator of them all is price action, in my humble opinion. TA is all about pattern recognition, and the patterns that we are looking at are made by the price action. Each day a chart will show you the opening, closing, highest and lowest prices of the day. I find that the best way to show this on a chart is with Japanese candlesticks. There are a couple of good books on this subject, one by Steve Nissen and one by Louise Bedford. So you can go looking for those if you like, and I highly recommend them. Because the candlesticks are colour-coded, they tell you at a glance what happened that day after the market opened. I rate volume as the next most important indicator, as it shows how many shares changed hands that day, and you can compare it to other days to see if it is higher or lower than usual. Because we're using charts, we can easily apply a moving average to these indicators, which will give us a midpoint to compare our day's action with. As most good things comes in threes, the third part of this indicator package is trend lines. In an uptrending market, you draw the trend line under the price action, and in a downtrending market, you draw the trend line at the top of the price action. These are support points for both types of markets. You can go ahead and draw a second trend line at the top or bottom of the price action to form channels, but the support one is the important one. There are heaps of other indicators, and no matter how many times that I say that you can do without them, I know that you will try them all. I'm just going back to trend lines for a moment. Don't get too stressed about where, or get too anal about exactly where you drop that trend line in. To be honest, the best place is probably at the bottom of the low point for the day, but it can be just as good if you put it under the closing point. But don't get too picky about all that. You'll find your rhythm with that as it goes along. Now, as I said, no matter how many times I say it, that you can do without all the other indicators, I do know that you will go and try them, because that's exactly what I did. For a time, you will fall in love with some of them, and you will swear black and blue that you have found the Holy Grail, but eventually you will work out that all indicators are trailing indicators, and you are still going to have to use your judgment as to which trades to enter. None of the indicators are going to tell you what to do next. They're just going to tell you what happened in the past, which goes back to their old pattern recognition. A few quick words regarding candlestick patterns. There are some very powerful candlestick patterns that will give very high probability trades, but only in the short term and only after confirming signals. When you've read the books, you'll understand what that means. If you are a medium-term trader, that will be less helpful than if you are a short-term trader. Trend lines. The longer that the price action respects a trend line, the more powerful it becomes. I remember when I was learning about these things, they seemed so otherworldly, but the fact is that they will become very familiar to you very quickly, so just give yourself time to absorb them and see where they fit into your trading style. There will be times when certain other indicators will come in handy. Treat them like tools in a toolbox and bring them out when you need them. Spider has collected a lot of woodworking tools over the years, but some only see the light of day once a year. But that does not make that tool any less valuable than the others. The right tool at the right time for the right job. If you've only just started out, you'll find it difficult to believe, but all this stuff will become second nature to you within a relatively short time. The mechanics of trading, particularly of you if you are using TA and not messing your mind up with FA, are relatively simple. The real work comes when you get down to setting stop losses and deciding how much to risk on each trade, which is basically money management. The toughest part of trading is recognizing and executing an exit so as to trap the maximum amount of profit. Fear is the hunter. Fear of losing and fear of missing out. You'll hear it said that no one ever went broke from taking a profit. Well, I'm here to tell you that they did. Getting out of a winning trade too early is nearly as bad as staying in a losing trade too long. You probably won't know what any of this means until you have been through a few things. So for that reason, there is absolutely no substitute for experience. Nothing beats putting your money on the table. Once you have risked your money a few hundred times, you will start to understand that your biggest challenge is now upon you. Your emotional response to winning and losing money are an indicator as to the likelihood of you surviving as a trader. As I write this, we are in the midst of one of the longest bull runs in Australian trading history, and we are also coming out of a brief, a couple of months, sideways drift. Most people have only experienced a market that just keeps going up. To them, it all seems very easy, but some are wondering why they did not take more out of this market while it has been running. The reason? It's just like the rest of life. We get way too close to the action and forget to step back and look at the bigger picture. If we get too close, we just don't recognize what is happening because we are too busy being in the middle of it. For that reason, major trading decisions should always be confirmed by evaluating weekly charts. If you are at the beginning, you need to know that this is a very long journey, and I know that you don't want to hear that because at the beginning I certainly didn't. You just want to get through all this technical stuff so that you can get to the money. The problem is, the only way you will survive, I'll say that again, the only way you will survive is to turn that thought off and face the fact that you have a great deal to learn and that some of it is going to be very painful indeed. Most people don't make it as traders, not because they cannot master the basics, but because they are not prepared to make the psychological changes that are necessary to succeed. Now, a lot of people really don't want to hear that, and a lot of people who have been trading for a long time and aren't doing as well as they would like to be doing really get angry whenever I say that and when other people say that. But it's a fact. Finally, a brief word about fundamental analysis. Most traders feel the need to dabble in FA, as they feel that they may be missing out on something if they don't. I started out on FA because I did not know the TA existed. I cannot mix the two, as my brain is not able to filter out the distraction that fundamental analysis presents. I also worked out that FA is old news, so old in fact, that it is mostly useless with regard to timely entries, or exits for that matter. So for these and many other reasons, I strongly urge my listeners to avoid fundamental analysis when it comes to making entry or exit decisions. If you're a bit slow, like Spider, you will benefit from a keep it simple approach. Stick to learning chart patterns and you will give yourself a fighting chance of living happily ever after. This is Spider in the back of the Jag again. I did try my last podcast sitting in front of the fire, but the echo factor in my lounge room is just stunning. So this is Spider from the back of the Jag signing off. Thank you for listening.